I missed the calendar you sent me years ago. I've got this cheapo one here, and
Oh,
I had that beautiful one with European scenes many years ago.
So I should make a new
and
one.
So we were just talking about what we should talk about first, and the thought was the date, and none of us could quite pin the date down.
No.
We're pretty sure it's Friday.
Yeah.
The 12th?
Friday.
Or the 11th?
Well, I think. 12th.
It's the 11th. That's what the
really?
Calendar says.
So you were
yeah.
right.
What month is it?
Yeah. I'm supposed to play something Hawaiian.
Yeah.
I don't have any Hawaiian songs I can play in this tuning. We could try the lively version of that. No, 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 that's not going to work. Never mind. Anyway, it is Friday, August 11th. We're here trying to do a little TG News with our two esteemed visitors and guests and
again?
A couple favorite people in the world. And we even had a drop-in, a cameo from Vanessa last night.
Yep.
That was nice. So Vanessa, all the important people are in California now, except for all the campers that we're waiting on next week. There's a few of them here. So, and what have we been? This has been a really interesting week so far. I have no idea what's going on at TG, as you guys probably figured out, but that's not fair. But a lot of music going on in here.
Absolutely.
I've been trying to give my normal lessons, and we've got this soundtrack going on in the back patio that is just fabulous. So my students, as they're waiting for lessons, are getting completely entertained and you know, the joy of hearing cool songs.
And we've been joining your students
yeah.
as well. That's been great.
I think they're. I mean, I'm glad you got a chance to meet some of them. And like I've told you, it's my life is so spoiled because my students are like my favorite people in the world to hang out with. You know, and so they come here and they pay me to hang out with me. It's like it's way too weird, but hopefully they're learning something. Anyway, welcome again. I don't know how many people saw our whatever we called it, the IGC countdown, but some people probably don't watch that because they're not coming. But they probably still watch the news. So what's new with you guys? What can you tell us about this week that has happened?
Bike rides and breakfast.
Bike rides, and yeah, we dragged Chris out up a trail a few days ago, and then came home. We have a nice little breakfast of fruit and yogurt and things like that.
And Californian fruit tastes like nothing in the world.
Absolutely.
Mm.
Yeah.
Well, we've spoiled them by getting most of the fruit from like farmers markets and, you know, basically fresh from the farms rather than the grocery store.
Not to mention the fine Californian wines.
Wine. Oh.
You guys been drinking wine while you're here?
Oh, have we?
You?
Have we?
Yeah.
You? I can't remember.
I notice a lot of bottles in the recycling bin, and I'm wondering, you know,
how did that happen?
Well, how did I miss that?
No,
I must have blacked it out.
Yeah.
So, do you guys want to sing a song? I mean, I know it's early in the morning, but
we can try.
What are some that you sing together that I might know the chords to?
If I could read your mind.
Yep.
Oh.
Yeah.
Sure.
Yep.
Did we do that? You've been doing that capo, right? You want to be in the key?
Capo two.
Yep,
right.
Two.
He does it in capo two. Right?
Okay.
So.
Okay. Here we go. A treat from.
Just prompt me if I get the words wrong. If you could read my mind, love, what a thought and a tip.
That's it. What a tale. And he never messes up words
you
anyway.
You see, I never
Let's
mess
try it again.
Up. Thanks.
Don't worry, we won't edit that out.
Great.
There is no editing allowed
It'll
in the news.
Looking,
you know,
looking forward to this.
The only time, I think there was one time I had to edit a news thing, and it was because of like this something horrible had happened out on the street. It's like a truck fell from the moon and landed like right across the street, and it was. So I think I did edit one thing, but we're not doing that on this one.
If you could read my mind, love, what a tale my thoughts would tell. Just like an old-time movie, about a ghost from a wishing well. In a castle dark, or a fortress strong with chains upon my feet. You know that ghost is me. Set free as long as I'm can't see. If I could read your mind, love, what a tale your thoughts could tell. Just like an old-time novel, out of gust from a wishing
well. Did that for us.
I know. In a castle
bar. Did that.
Where the heartaches come, the hero would be me. But heroes often fail. You won't read that book again, because the ending's just too hard to take.
You guys, you're just not,
the
not
effects
used
of wearing,
to wearing
Hawaiian shirts.
Yeah.
Just the uniform.
Yeah. Shakes
yeah.
you up.
Yeah, yeah, that's okay. And the pressure of, yeah. of you know, going out to twelves of people who might watch this. So, anyway, we were talking the other day about Gordon Lightfoot because, somebody yeah. that we both really think is...
great storyteller,
Yeah.
And still out there doing it.
Still out there, kind of... hanging by a thread, it seems, and it's kind of a miracle, though, that he's still out there. So, yeah, one of those great songwriters. We're talking about a lot of other ones, too, but anything you guys want to talk about or questions you have to ask the world, the audience here?
Mm-hmm.
Things they could address on world peace?
Well, hi to Michelle.
Oh!
I know she's watching.
Yeah.
And,
hi, Michelle. Sorry I missed you last
sorry.
Year.
Yeah.
You're not here. So I miss my roommate this year. But I have a fabulous Lynn as
That's
my
right.
roommate this
Lynn
year.
Lynn will be your roommate this year. She should be okay.
Yeah.
Yeah, we're looking forward to seeing Lynn. And playing her blues things. This is one she plays. That's right, we were talking a lot about ragtime and jazzy kinds of stuff like this. Kind of a new stuff, or stuff you hadn't heard a lot of.
Yeah.
Like goofy lyrics.
Yeah.
You know, this one is called, this one's called That'll Never Happen No More. And the lyrics are basically about, you know, getting involved with the wrong woman and beat up by her boyfriend and stuff like that. You know, it goes something like that. Met a gal at the cabaret. Pretty papa, I'm going your way. Man knew what it's all about. Waiting at home just to throw me out. Broke my nose and split my chin. Said, don't let me catch you here again. Whipped me from the kitchen back to the door. Beat me with a chair till my head got sore. But that'll never happen no more. That'll never happen no more. Anyway, so one of the recurring themes in old blues tunes is, anyway, getting involved with the wrong people. Which is where this song came from. I think, I'm not sure if I mentioned this last week when I was talking about that song, but you know, his story on that was that he got a call in the middle of the night by somebody who wanted to come see him, and he didn't think it was a good idea. She came anyway, and in the hour between the time that she called and he got there, he put this song together.
Oh.
And that's the kind of like the whole thing. It's like, oh, I shouldn't see this person. But which explains also why it's fairly simple as far as the chords go, and just this cool little riff and stuff in there. Yeah, so let's see. So we did have a little reunion last night of CC Ness, but I don't think they actually played a song. Part of them did, right?
Karina. Yeah. Karina Vanessa did.
Yeah.
And they did I mess up again?
Yeah, they just went into a song that, you know, that wasn't one you guys had worked on as the trio, right?
Yeah, no. And it's from a famous Dutch singer, probably the greatest at the moment. The greatest singer in Holland, and yeah, it's a very beautiful song. Yeah, but we haven't played it, the three of us. So.
Yeah, we'll maybe approach that later.
Yeah.
It is. It's always interesting when we talk about, or to me at least, songs that are like so popular here, and that you know you've never heard, and of course the opposite is true too. You know, like I think you guys are sometimes surprised to find out that somebody that was huge in Europe.
Never heard of them,
because you kind of think that you think it's almost a worldwide thing.
Yeah,
you know. And I know one of the discussions we had the other day was even the Beatles had this, and it's like they didn't want to come to America, they were afraid almost, you know. And in their head it was like until we have a hit, you know. And luckily enough they did by the time the tour was booked and stuff in 1964. They'll never last anyway. I'm sure that's it with most of those English bands, you know. They'll just. But it was one of those singers. Ultravox, for example, was one of the ones we were talking about.
Europe.
Vanessa was shocked when I said, you know, I never heard of those guys, even though that song, I guess, was a big thing in a movie, maybe, or something. The Final Countdown.
I'm not sure if it was in a movie.
It was just heard ad nauseum in Europe.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Maybe a prominent least example these days would be Robbie Williams.
Oh, yeah.
Who is huge in Europe. He's never made a bad song, and I think over here nobody knows who he is. I think the music travels from the West, from America over to us, better than it travels from us over here, with the exception of British Invasion in the 60s and other big groups that just get worldwide coverage.
Yeah. There was a progressive band that Greg Lake kind of promoted in the early 70s called PFM, an Italian band, Premiata Forneria Marconi or something, you know, but love these guys. But the first album we heard over here was Emerson, Lake and Palmer had started their own label, Manticore, and they were looking for bands to do stuff. And so they became familiar with this band, and they ended up, and they'd already made an album or two, but what Lake had them do was remake many of their songs and sing them all in English, you know, so which for them was completely phonetic. They didn't know much at all, you know, so they're just trying to get through these words, but it actually made it did pretty well over here, and made me in particular go out and look for their Italian albums, which anyway, and they're still making albums. I mean, they're still pretty neat. They took 15 years off or something, but I even have a lesson on one of them. River of Life. Oh, I mentioned a song. I have no idea how it goes now, but it's still, I did a little, there was a, a lesson on one of theirs that went back when I was doing some progressive rock things just to upset Matt. Oh no, wait, we will edit this one a little bit now. Matt, we miss you, buddy, and he did tell me yesterday that he is going to try to get up here in the next week or so before you leave town.
Great.
Cool. So we're certainly hoping that could work, because I mean he was here a couple months ago, but it's like, and it'd been like 3 or 4 years since I'd seen him. You know, so
wow.
We kind of travel in different. Well, he kind of travels, and I kind of stay in my own same little circle. I don't go far. You know. Let's see. Anything else crossing anybody's mind that should be brought up today, or any songs you maybe would like to hear, or do you want to sing another one?
What do you reckon?
Are we up for another song? Which one?
Can I mess up another one?
Let's see, because we went through a bunch of Gordon Lightfoot songs, kind of just only part way. I mean, like, you know, as we were talking about him, I was remembering a few that I used to play a lot. But maybe no more songs then, huh?
Save them up.
Okay.
Yeah.
All right. Let's see. I think that is it. Everybody, camp wise, I should be getting some emails out to everybody to make sure that everybody knows what's going on there soon. But I would like. Well, never mind. I'll save all that for later too. So. Okay, I'll play us out with something. What? Any songs you'd like me to play? You already asked me to play.
We were listening to On the Horizon the other night.
Oh.
On a wonderful evening with a wonderful wine, and it was. And Neil was listening for the first time in a very long time. He said to himself, playing the guitar over the speakers in the garden, and we just sat back and drank it in, and and you sat and listened to yourself for the first time.
It's funny when that happens, because it I do feel kind of disconnected from it, or not disconnected, but I feel like I'm listening to it relatively objectively. Even when I hear stuff from like early album I made, the album of Beatles tunes, you know, that I think this was like 30 years ago, and I think now I'm I feel like I'm much better now, you know, that I play these things differently and stuff. And then like a song of that will pop on. And my first reaction is, oh man, I could probably do that so much better now. But then I'll listen to it. And I think I'm actually pretty proud of it. You know, it's like, I think I'm happy. I don't look back and say, oh, that was terrible. What was I thinking, you know, or something. And, so it is, and sometimes songs come on that I can't even remember how to play at all. You know, now On the Horizon is one that I, you know, usually can get through. I say that it's like I kind of think of my songs as like my kids or something too. Like I, you know, generally like most of them. There are a couple ones that I do have to think. What was I thinking? There's one on Cobble Creek called A Slight Miscalculation, and all I remember about it was mostly improvised in the studio. And my plan on it was to play as many wrong notes as possible. And so it was just a weird little experiment. And when it was over, I thought, you know, I'm just going to put that on the album. It's kind of like Neil Young with the Sugar Mountain Story. It's like, you know, he said he wrote 128 verses to that song. And when he was trying to decide which four to use, he you know, was having trouble picking one. And he said, there was one that was just one of the dumbest things I ever wrote. It was like the worst lyrics I ever wrote in my life. And I thought, as a frame of reference, I better put it in the song. There was a line about, now you're underneath the stairs and you're giving back some glares to the people that you met, and it's your first cigarette. You know, and And so anyway, this is a long story he tells in the middle of it from a 1971 concert. I've shown that bootleg before called I'm Happy You All Came Down. But anyway, you know, that's what he goes into right there and says that I just had to put it in the song. And so he says, so if everybody will sing the chorus along with me when it's over, I'll feel a whole lot better, you know, because and this is the first time most of these people have heard this song, but the chorus is so easy, and it'll live on Sugar Mountain, yeah, et cetera, and stuff. But, so I don't know what I was thinking when I put that a slight miscalculation on there. So if anybody out there knows anything about, knows how to play that song, send it in. Somebody should put that in for a student review, which I don't think the student reviews are working either now. Anyway, okay, that's probably enough for today. But we'll try to shoot some more stuff, especially more songs over the next few days, and get some practiced performances maybe, huh?
Might help.
Maybe, yeah, I don't know.
It'll help me.
Yeah. And we could have lyric sheets up and stuff like that too. That would help. But then you'd have to be able to read like at a pretty far distance, right?
Yeah, which I can't.
Okay.
And you know.
Yeah, so. Okay, well, we're off to the Santa Cruz Mountains to hang out with my sister and her husband and Nani and you too. And
could there be a winery on the way?
There might be a few. There might be a few in the way that we have to check out.
Dang.
And a few others on the way.
So
and,
much suffering yeah. here.
Yeah, it's rough. So, anyway, that's it for today. But really hope to have some more songs for everybody in the near future. And really glad you guys are here too.
Great to be.
Absolutely.
Yeah. All right. On to next week.